Babe Ruth. Yankee Stadium in New York City. They call it the house that Ruth built with good reason. His mighty bat was the magnet that drew the crowds. That bat, the terror of major league pitchers, had won him all that a nation could offer. Wealth and fame and popularity. The cheers of the crowd. The love and admiration of America's children to whom his signature was precious. He had everything, yet he knew disappointment and heartbreak. Yet in the end, he learned to overcome failure and earned a deathless place in the American story. For George Herman Ruth, the beginning was in the slums of Baltimore, Maryland. His father's saloon and the slum streets were his playground. His playmates were tough, and the games they played were frowned on by the police. He wound up in reform school, St. Mary's, run by kindly priests. They trained him to become a tailor, but in his spare time, young Ruth played baseball. Played it so well that in 1914, he went almost directly from St. Mary's to the big leagues. A rookie pitcher with the Boston Red Sox, salary $2,500 a year. To you, a kid from the slums, it seemed like all the money in the world. But your bat soon became more valuable to the Red Sox than your pitching arm, so you were shifted to the outfield where you could take your turn at bat every day. The result, a new home run champion and the beginning of a new era in baseball. Ruth hit 29 home runs during the season of 1919. Some observers called it a freak the Babe would never equal. But Colonel Jake Ruppert, owner of the New York Yankees, didn't agree. He paid the Red Sox $100,000 for Ruth's contract and paid the Babe $20,000 a year to don the Yankee uniform. The Yankees had never won a pennant before Ruth joined the team in 1920. That year, sparked by the Bambino's phenomenal hitting, they came close. Next year, with Ruth shattering his own record by slamming out 59 home runs, they finally made it. Their first American League pennant and World Series victory. 1921, the roaring 20s were getting underway. Women's skirts were going up over the knee, and morals were going down. Bathing beauties began competing for the title of Miss America. Remember Tom Mix? In movie land, he rode the range in defense of law and order. While in the big cities, mobsters shouted out with Tommy guns for possession of an empire of bootleg whiskey. Jack Dempsey had just pounded his way to the heavyweight championship of the world. Big Bill Tilden was the Mr. Big of the tennis courts. Bobby Jones was polishing up the swing that would soon make him ruler of golfdom. Heroes all, and the greatest of them was the Sultan of Swat, Babe Ruth. Greatest hero and the greatest sucker. 1925. As always, the fans jammed Yankee Stadium to see Babe Ruth ram out the homers. Instead, they saw a fat man swinging ineffectually at the ball. Fame had gone to Ruth's head. The Bambino had become an overstuffed playboy. From the batting champion of 1924, he became the big bust of 1925. Had the brightest star of baseball suddenly fizzled out? Was the Bambino finished? It looked that way. Failure in mid-career. Was he washed up as the sports writers and fans predicted? That winter, the Babe proved them wrong. The comeback trail was hard, but Ruth was determined to sweat off that excess poundage. When the 1926 baseball season opened, the Babe was ready.